seats. Please stand for our graduates and remain standing for the national anthem that will be sung immediately after the graduates are in their places. Thank you.
Thank you. And teachers should definitely be thanking for that. Let's make the future ours, one obstacle at a time. As a wise man once said, life's not a track meet, it's a marathon. Thank you.
Next, I want to thank Coach Quinn, who I've never had as a teacher, but has been a great softball coach and remember sitting in first or second grade music class at Green Mountain, and Mr. Dahl played this Japanese children's song from out of the little textbook. I thought it was so beautiful back then that I nearly cried. I remember in sixth grade, I was out for a walk in my old neighborhood with a camera. The sun was only just about to set, and it hit the clouds in just the right way. It made it look like the sky was being ripped apart by fire, silver, and showers of light, all right above the trees and mountains. To this day, that sky is the best picture I've ever taken, and the only one I've ever had framed. I remember each year moving around the school and seeing thousands of stunning things. Flower petals falling from the trees, light streaming down from the glass windows above the main staircase, watching the sun rise over the field, and, best of all, seeing all the people that come to care about grow and learn. I do these little things from day to day, like stopping to see or hear what's going on around me, so that I miss as little as possible, because I'll never know if that one moment I missed would have been the best of my life. Missing those moments is one of my biggest pet peeves, because I'll always regret not gaining the experience that comes with them. I've done my best to create as many perfect moments for memories that I could here at our school. Each year for 6 years, I've made new friends, taking part in new things. Quick shout out to my debate and philosophy club people. And I hope I've given all of you at least one good memory I'm ready to take with you. But this isn't it for me. I plan on getting a hold of every story, every little anecdote, and living them as long as I possibly can, just to gather as many amazing memories as I can stand. One last thing before whatever is scheduled is after me. Thank you. Thank you all for giving me a place in your lives here at Klahowya. And thank you for giving me all the memories that have made me who I am today. Now, go on out and have some fun, make some new memories, and change your life forever. Thanks for listening.
Mr. Lindbergh is a wonderful. commitment that we can all make here and now. We cannot pretend that what we do today does not matter. We cannot excuse ourselves from daily little bits of good by claiming that the big things we will do later will prove who we are. A pattern of service through loving and kind small choices may well be your biggest choice, and will be, for most of us, our legacy. To serve in this way, first we have to know who we are and what we are. I'm an English teacher. I love words. I revel in their power and what I can make them do. When I read excellent ones, I can go to any place and any time. I can share my feelings, adventures, hopes, and fears of people I will never meet. I can understand lives and experiences that are not my own. When I write them, I record a piece of myself forever. But it is when I speak that I see the real, amazing, sometimes frightening power of words. Through the words I speak and do not speak, I can make another's day or break it. I might be one person who bothers to break into another's solitary world, draws him or her back from lonely despair, or remind him or her that others notice. I might also be the one who cements another's surety that he or she does not matter. I might, however, tip the balance and turn what was not a good day into a great one. Too few people manage this huge responsibility with care, yet it is here where we should take the utmost care. We must choose words with painful care. We have to be honest with each other. We're searching for someone who will be. We have to say what we mean and do what we say. We have to treat each other with enough care that others know we see them and are happy to share some time with them. It is not enough, however, to be careful with our words. We have to also hear the words of others. And when we respond, we have to be respectful, honest, and careful. We have to remember that each conversation, including the others that would be easy to turn away from, are important to the person who has something to say or who needs to hear something. We recognize our humanity and our own when we read them and when we do not. This pattern of small choices, listening, speaking kindly, including rather than excluding, smiling, lending a hand, honors each
staff members, family, friends, guests, and community partners, it's an honor and a pleasure to be here today to address the class of 2014. We have enjoyed the opportunity to watch you grow intellectually, physically, and emotionally. One of the strengths of Klahowya is that we establish long-lasting relationships with our students. However, these quality relationships make it difficult for us to say goodbye. I know that I speak the entire Klahowya community when I say that we will miss you and that we hope that you please stay in touch. We have, together, amassed a tremendous amount of experiences while learning at Klahowya that will help guide and shape our future as we move to various parts of the world and continue our journeys outside the walls of our little school and our little community. The memories of the laughter and the tears that reverberate in our minds and our hearts will guide and impact our decisions in the years to come. Each class that graduates from Klahowya has a unique personality. The class of 2014 is characterized by the ability to laugh in the face of uncertainty because of the incredible confidence that they have in their own abilities. I marvel at your ability to decipher meaning from constant, contradictory, instant information. Your world is made up of the here and now. Unlike my generation, you have instant access to information through a variety of sources that didn't even exist when I went through school. Your ability to sift and sort through the barrage of information to determine what matters to you is amazing, and it will suit you well in the future. You are in a position to shape the future more than any other graduating class that I've been a part of. Your use of technology to communicate will shape what we do with future generations. In fact, just this morning in practice, we couldn't remember which side we were texting on. But within 10 seconds, Associate Arts degree.
101 of you attended Klahowya for 6 years. Several of you are artists, writers, athletes, and musicians, have earned numerous awards, and you will continue your artistic and athletic careers at the collegiate level. Each year, Klahowya staff selects 2 outstanding seniors as the students of the year. Students are chosen according to leadership, citizenship, academic standing, and school achievement. We honor these students by placing their names on the plaque at the entrance of the school. I'd like the 2014 Students of the Year to please rise as your names are read. The 2014 Klahowya Secondary School Students of the Year are Parker Beach, and Shannon Chacha. Superintendent Vickers, please join me at the podium. Class of 2014 has labored long and hard to reach this day. They have distinguished themselves as scholars and outstanding citizens and are ready to move from Central Kitsap School District toward their promising futures. I am at ease as principal of Klahowya Secondary School to present the class of 2014 to Mr. David Vickery, superintendent of Central Kitsap School District. I certify that the men and women who are to receive diplomas are prepared for graduation as prescribed by the laws of the state of Washington and the rigorous requirements of the Central Kitsap School District. Mr. McVickery, I present to you the Klahowya Secondary School class of 2014.
Thank you, Mr. Stevens. As superintendent of Central Kitsap School District, I'm proud to receive the Klahowya Secondary School class of 2014. Mr. Stevens, teachers, staff, parents, and supportive community, you've done an outstanding job in the preparation of these graduates, and we honor you as we honor them. Your principal certifies that each of you graduates has completed a course of study in keeping with the requirements of the Central Kitsap School District and the laws of the state of Washington, and each of you is now prepared for commencement. As your diplomas are conferred, you will join other proud Klahowya Secondary School graduates who have gone forward to take their place in a very challenging world. As you join in this proud tradition of excellence, we are moved by your achievements, and we see in you our very best hope for the future. We know you will live up to our trust. And now, it is my great pleasure to invite members of the Board of Directors of the Central Kitsap School District to come forward and participate in conferring diplomas on the graduates of the Klahowya Secondary School class of 2014.
Thank you.
Jeanette Rose Erickson.